Good evening, students. In today's class, in the chapter Comparing Quantities from page 121, we will continue with the try this third problem. Okay. In the last class, we have done up to second question of try this. Today, we will start with third one. An almirah is sold at ₹5,225 after allowing a discount of 5%. Find its marked price. Okay. So it is given an almirah is sold at ₹5,225. Selling price is ₹5,225 after allowing a discount of 5%. We have to find what is the marked price. So now let us start doing this. So what is given for us? An almirah selling price is given. Selling price of almirah is ₹5,225. This is given. And one more value they have given, discount rate is 5%. So what do you know normally? Discount rate is given at 5% of marked price, is it not? So shall I write this? This is as 5% of 5% on marked price. 5% on marked price is the discount given. So now let me find out now what is marked price. Now, so we know now marked price minus discount is equal to sales price. Is it not? This we know. So, we don't know what is marked price. Let us have marked price minus what is discount 5/100 of marked price. Is it not? Discount will be 5% on marked price. So, 5/100 on marked price is equal to sales price 5,225. Now, this we are going to simplify as marked price minus, see, 5/100 marked price is equal to 5225. So this can I make it as fractional part and LCM 100, so that this will become 100 marked price minus 5 times marked price is 5225. So 100 marked price minus 5 is 95. By 100 of marked price is 5,225. So from this you get marked price is 5,225. 95 by 100 get transposed as 100 by 95. Now this we have to simplify. Which table shall we take? Which shall we take? 5 table. 5 will go. 5 20s are. And this 5 will go, 5 ones are 5, 19 times. Now we will check 19 will go in 525 how many times. Since 19 is a prime number, we have to divide directly. So in our rough column, here we divide and see. 5225 divided by 19. 19 will go, 19 twos are 38. Then we get 12, 12 minus 8, 4, 132. 19 will go in this 7 times. So 9 sevens are 63, 3 carry 6, 7 ones are 7 plus 6, 133. Then again when we simplify, 9 and 5, 95. 95, 19 will go, 19 fives are 95. So it gone as 275. So, we get 275 into 20. 19 will go in 5225, 275 times multiplied by this numerator 20. So, we get now 0, 2 5s are 10, carry 1, 2 7s are 14 plus 1, 15, 5 carry 1, 2 2s are 4 plus 1, 5. So, this is our marked price. So, we got now marked price as 5,500. So, this is what we should find from our solution. So the question we will, I'll repeat because this is very important question for you to understand. An almira is sold 5,225 after allowing a discount of 5%. Find its marked price. So here we are doing given, what is given? Selling price, sales price 5,225. Discount rate is 5%. Discount where you will apply normally it is 5% on marked price, is it not? So 5% on marked price. But we know sales price is what? Marked price minus discount. So we write marked price minus discount. We got it as 5%. 5 by 100 on marked price is equal to 5,225. So this we will simplify by taking the LCM and we get as 95 by 100 of marked price is 5,225. So marked price is 5,225 multiplied by the LHS 95 by 100 get transposed to RHS as reciprocal 100 by 95. So we cancel with the 5 table first. In 5, 100 will go 20 times, 95 will go 19 times and 19 will go in 5,225 directly 275 times. So 275 into 20 is 5,500. That is what we should find. Find its marked price. So we find the marked price as 5,500 rupees. Okay. So now in that way we have completed from page number 121 all the three try this problem. Now let us move on to the next page. In the next page 123, in 121 there is 122 there is no try this. So in page number 123, in page number 123 we have try this. In this, you have one question with the three subdivision. So, question is, find selling price if the profit of 5% is made on a cycle of rupees 700 with 50 rupees as overhead charges. First question. Second question is, a lawn mower bought at rupees 1150 with rupees 50 as transportation charges. Then a fan bought for rupees 560. And expenses of 40 made on its repairs. So you know this overhead charge, transportation charge, repair charge, everything we will add with the how much they bought and we make it as total cost price. And then for that cost price, 5% of profit, how much we will find. And we add with cost price to find the selling price. Okay. Now let us move on to the question. So what we have to find in this, they have given, you find selling price, okay? Now, what is given? Given profit 5%. Now, in the first question, first subdivision, they have given a cost of the cycle. Cycle cost rupees 700. And overhead charge as rupees 50. Therefore, what is our total cost price? Total cost price is rupees 750. So first we add up the cost, original cost with overhead charge and we find total cost. Now for this total cost price, profit 5%, how much we find? Now we therefore, profit 5% of rupees 750. That is how much? 5 by 100 into 750. So 1010 get cancelled. 5 will go in 10 two times. Then we get 2 will go in 75 as 37 rupees 50 paisa. Now profit is 37.50. So what should be the selling price? Therefore, selling price is cost price plus profit. Cost price is 750 rupees. Profit just now we found 5% of 750 is 37 rupees 50 paisa. So when we add we get 787 rupees 50 paisa. So the total selling price is now 787.50. In the similar way, we will do the second sum also. In the second subdivision, they have given a lawnmower cost is ₹1,150 and transportation charge it is given as ₹50. Therefore, what is the total cost price? Total cost price is when we add, we get ₹1,200. Now in this, profit is 5%. So we write profit is equal to 5% of ₹1,200. What is it? 5 by 100 into 1,200. Two zeros get cancelled. 5 12s are 60. ₹60 is a profit. Therefore, what is selling price? Cost price plus profit. Cost price is 1,200. Profit is 60. So, ₹1,260. Okay. So, the total selling price of the lawnmower is 1,260. Next, third subdivision. In the third subdivision, they have given cost price of fan is ₹560. And repair expenses, ₹40. So, what is total cost price? Therefore, total cost price is ₹600. 560 plus 40, 600. Now, what is profit given? Profit is 5% of ₹600. That is how much? 5 by 100 into 600. Two zeros get cancelled. 5 6s are ₹30. So, profit is 30. Therefore, selling price of fan is cost price plus profit. Cost price is 600. Profit is 30. So, that is ₹630. Okay. So, in that way, we have completed from page 123. In the page 123, at the top, there was a try this with a 3 subdivision question. We have completed. Next, in the same page, at the end, we have one sum. Try this sum. Now, this we will do. A shopkeeper bought 2 TV set at ₹10,000 each. Okay. Read the question carefully. A shopkeeper bought 2 TV set at ₹10,000 each. 1 TV set is 10,000. So, 2 TV set. 2 means how much it should be? 10,000 into 2? 20,000. He sold 1 at a profit of 10% and other at a loss of 10%. Find whether he made an overall profit or loss. Okay. So, he bought 2 TV set each 10,000 rupees. So, for 1 he got 10% profit. For another 1 he lost 10%. But overall, whether he made, overall means what? Together, he made profit or loss, we should find. Okay. Now, let us do the sum. So, the shopkeeper bought 2 TV set, is it not? So, we will write cost of each TV is ₹10,000. Therefore, cost of 2 TV is ₹20,000. Is it not? 10,000 multiplied by 2. Since it's a small number, I am writing it directly. ₹20,000. Now, for the first TV, when he sold first TV, it is given, he got profit 10%. Is it not? For the first TV, profit is 10%. So, what is the profit amount? Profit amount is 10% on cost price. That is 10 by 100 into 10,000. Because for each TV now we should calculate. Two zeros. Two zeros get cancelled. 1000 rupees. 10 into 100, 1000. So he got profit amount is 1000. Therefore, selling price of first TV set is cost price plus profit. What is cost price? 10,000. Profit is 1000 he got. Totally 10,000. How much it should come? 11,000 rupees. I'll make this as first equation. Okay. Now, because for the second TV set also we should find. Now, similarly, how we found for the first TV profit 10%. For the second TV, it is given loss 10%. For second TV, cost price is same, 10,000 rupees. But it is given loss rate. Loss rate is 10%. So, what is the loss amount? Loss amount ...10% of cost to price. That is 10 by 100 of 10,000. Now, two zeros get cancelled, 1,000. So, loss is 1,000. Now, what is selling price of second TV? Cost price minus loss. Whenever we have a loss, we subtract from cost price. So, what is cost price? 10,000 minus loss 1,000. We get 9,000 rupees. This I will make it as second equation. Now, what happens? Total selling price we should find. Total selling price of both the TVs together, selling price of first TV plus selling price of second TV, that gives you the total selling price. So, selling price of first TV with profit 10% is 11,000. Selling price of second TV with loss 10% is 9,000. So, what is the total? 11,000 plus 9,000 is 20,000. Okay. So, now you can see when we started, we found the cost price of two TV set is 20,000. Here, selling price of two TV set is also 20,000. So, what we got now here? Therefore, cost price of two TV set is equal to selling price of two TV set. Each are 20,000 rupees, is it not? So, when the cost price and selling price are same, what do you know? It is not a profit, not a loss. Therefore, overall, that is at the end, no profit or no loss. So, what he spent, he got it back. So, it is called it as when cost price and selling price are same, there is no profit or no loss. Okay. Now, let us move on to the page number 125. In this, before the exercise, there are two questions. They have given think, discuss and write. So, let us do this. Okay. What is given? Think. Read the question. Think what it is there. We will discuss. We will know. Explain how we have to do and we write the solution. First question. 2 times a number is 100% increase in the number. If we take half the number, what would be the decrease in percent? Read once again. 2 times a number. We don't know what is the number. So, 2 times a number is 100% increase in the number. If we take half the number, what would be the decrease in percentage? So, now we will do this one. 2 times a number. So, we don't know what is the number, no? Let us write, let the number we assume it as x. Now it is given, if we decrease the number, what will happen? Decrease the number. That is what is given. If we take half the number, decrease, it is given half the number. What is that half the number? X by 2. Now, what is now we have to find what is decrease percentage. Okay. Decrease percentage. Decrease percentage is how will you find how much it is decreased. It's like your discount. Discount by cost price. Cost marked price is original price, is it not? Decrease by original value into 100. We will find. So, what is decrease? X by 2. Original value is divided by x multiplied by 100. Now, how we will simplify? X by 2. This x goes to numerator as 1 by x into 100. Okay, here understand carefully. X by 2 divided by x. This x, we will bring it to numerator as the reciprocal 1 by x. So, x and x get cancelled. 2 will go in 150 times. Therefore, decrease percentage. Decrease percentage is 50%. Okay, half it has been decreased. So, it is given. 2 times a number is 100% increase, is it not? When a number is x, 2 times means 2x. It is multiplied 2 times. 100% it is increased. But if we take half the number is what? X by 2. What is the decrease in percentage? It is like our discount. Discount on the marked price into 100 we will write, no? So, decrease percent also. Decrease divided by original value into 100. Decrease is how much? X by 2 divided by original value x multiplied by 100. So, x by 2 divided by x will go reciprocal as 1 by x. So, that x and x get cancelled. 2 will go in 150 times. So, discount percent we got it as 50%. Now, let us do the second. By what percent is 2000 less than rupees 2400? By what percent is 2000 less than 2400? Is it the same as percent by which is 2400 more than 2%? Okay, read once again because it's same thing, only the number is twisted, so you may have a confusion. By what percent is 2000 less than 2400? Is it same the percent by when it is reversed, when 2400 is more than 2000? Okay, so here this less than more than plays a role. So let us move on to do that. So first we take this less than as first case, more than as second case. Okay, so by case 1. In the first case, given rupees 2000 less than rupees 2400. So now what it means? 2000 less than 2400. That is 2400. The difference is how much? Okay, if I say, therefore, difference is 400. 2400 minus 2400. So, what is decrease percentage? Decrease percentage is like the last sum what we did. Decrease divided by original value into 100. Here, decrease is 400. 2000 less than 2400. So, our original value is 2400 into 100. Two zeros will get cancelled. Now, for 24 and 400, which table we should take? Can we take 8 table? 8 5s are 40. 50 by 8 3s are 24. 50 by 3%. Next, case 2. Given 2000 is more than 2400. So it is increased now. It is increased 400 rupees. So what is increase percentage? Same way, 400. So here the original value is 2000 into 100. So when we cancel now, this will become 20, will go to 20, 20%. This is 50 by 3%. Here increase is 20%. The question is it the same? So you can easily compare and say they are not same. They are not same. Okay. So the sum again two or three times you repeat and watch the video so that you can understand clearly. Here the words more than and less than play an important role. You have to understand and do it. So practice this. And today's class homework is from page 121 to 124, example problems. Solve it as homework. Since already solution is there, it is easy for you to do it. If any difficulty, through WhatsApp, get it clear. Since the solutions are already learned in the example problems, easy for you to complete the homework. So, in the next video, let us start with exercise 8.2. Till then, please keep practicing and get clarify any doubts if you have.